Vsauce, Kevin here. Kids in the US haven't always had summers off. In rural areas, they went to school in summer and winter to help during planting and harvesting, while urban kids went year-round. In the mid-1800s, schools shifted to a standardized fall-spring schedule, allowing for family vacations and to give relief from buildings with no air conditioning. And doctors at the time supported this, saying that summers off would also help protect kids' brains from overuse. Meanwhile, kids are getting smarter. The Flynn effect shows that IQ scores improve markedly with each generation. Professor James Flynn found that if students 100 years ago took today's IQ test, they'd average 70, while if students today took the test 100 years ago, they'd average 130. Explanations include better healthcare, nutrition, and more schooling, and the fact that people before the scientific age were often adverse to classifying things they couldn't use, and didn't routinely engage in hypothetical or abstract thought. Neuropsychologist A.R. Luria tested this on a socially isolated farmer about 100 years ago, and it went something like this. What do a chicken and a dog have in common? Nothing. Chicken has two legs, dogs have four, chickens have wings, dogs don't. All right, you've explained how they're different, but how are they alike? They're not. All right, is there one word, though, that you could use for both of them? Nope. What about animal? Would the word animal fit? Yes. Online courses are commonplace now, but Sir Isaac Pitman actually established the first distance learning course in the 1840s. Pitman taught shorthand by mailing postcards to students and correcting the answers that they mailed back. In the 1920s, educational radio programs were considered textbooks in the air. And today, there are over 2,200 courses available online around the world for free. While South Korea is using robot teachers to help children with learning disabilities, a kindergarten in Switzerland is bringing education back to its roots. Literally. They have a school outside in the forest where kids attend rain or snow, learning to build shelters and fires alongside their ABCs. And as always, whoa! Thanks for watching. It's School of YouTube Week, and you can make a difference to the millions of children worldwide who won't be going back to school this year, whether due to lack of teachers, school materials, or worse. So click on the donate button if you can to help spread ideas and knowledge to everyone.